Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My name is Yusuf Diallo. Today I'm gonna be explaining my FYP 1 with my partner Abdul Bari. So our project is about Ahmad Office. We are developing a mobile application that's gonna help you as a student to communicate with Ahmad Office in a faster and more comfortable way. This application will help students to communicate with Ahmad staff and to submit their application without going to Ahmad Office. So basically, that is the introduction of our project. So next, let's talk about the problem statement. Okay, since we are living in the 20th century, so almost every student can afford a smartphone. That is why we are developing a mobile application that can save a student from going to Ahmad Office and queue in a long line. So next, the student might miss classes to go to submit their application. So second, sometimes students just go to Ahmad Office to ask about certain matters that can be done in a few minutes with a mobile application. So basically, these are the problem statements. Now let's talk about the objective of this project. The aim of this project is to establish a better communication between UIA student and the Ahmad Office. And also, when application is submitted in Ahmad Office, usually it takes 3 working days. So this issue is the main issue that we are trying to solve. And secondly, we would like to minimize the time needed to proceed an application. And some application or letters will be generated automatically.
So coming to the requirement gathering, 90 students out of 90 response from IIUM students say that they would like to have a mobile app that can provide a better server between them and Ahmad Office. Going to the use case diagram, there are 2 main actors in this system. The first actor, which is the student, and the second actor will be the Ahmad Officer. As you can see, the first step will be students registering into the account or into the application. Of course, the students will be using their university ID, which is a matric number and password. The second step will be student applying for documents. The students will have a list of documents for them to apply. These main documents were actually generated from the data collection where we ask students what are the reasons for them to visit Ahmad Office. The third step will be the Ahmad Officer proceeding with the application. So Ahmad Officer will receive all the information from students who applied for document, and they will proceed the document according to which document the student applied for. The next step will be Ahmad Officer uploading the document or notifying the students. The application will notify the students that their document is ready. Without the document taking much time like it is now. Documents actually take 3 days, as Yusuf explained before. The third one will be students downloading their document. So students, once the Ahmad Officer upload the document, students will be able to download the document through the application. Going to the prototype screens, there will be 4 main screens. The first screen will be the application screen, where students will have a list of applications for them to apply. There will be some of the text input for them to key in their information, such as passport number, full name, and matric number. The second screen will be the track screen. The track screen is actually a progress bar that can show the students how and when to get their document, or when the document will be ready, according to what kind of application they apply for. The third screen will be the inquiries screen. Students nowadays, they actually go to the Ahmad Office if they want to ask. Just to ask, they have to waste some time, but not anymore with the application. The application would allow students to communicate in real-time messages with the Ahmad Officer. The fourth screen will be the download screen. So students will be able to download the application through this screen once the application is ready.
Next, let's talk about the literature review. We compare our application with 3 main existing applications, which is Xander, and EMDS, and DocuSign.
Now coming to the 3 common figures between our app and these 3 apps. The first one is the user sign-in. These three apps actually have the user sign-in feature inside the app, which our app will have too. The second one is the file sharing system. So our app will be, of course, sharing files between students and IMED officer. And these three apps, they have this feature, which is the file sharing through the application. The third one is the document submission. The three applications, only EMGS and DocuSign have this feature, whereas Xcenter only allows file sharing, but not document submission through the app.
So ladies and gentlemen, to finish, our project is meant to save student time and also to establish a better communication channel between IMED office and the students. So that's all from us, and assalamu alaikum guys, have a good day.